Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. I'm Tel Stewart. In this video, I'm going to show you how I created the set extension effects in the Girls Don't Poop Poo Pourri commercial.
If you're thinking about doing set extensions, there's a few things you have to think about beforehand. First of all, you want to make sure that you prepare for the set extension beforehand. And that's the best case scenario. Sometimes you get a shot that you didn't see something beforehand and you have to add a set extension in order to fix the mistake, and that's okay. But it's ideal to prepare your shots beforehand, especially with set extensions, just so post-production is a lot smoother. I'm gonna show you how I made one stall look like multiple stalls next to each other with very little effort. Because we had to do this in a studio, and budgets were tight, so they were only able to make one stall, I had to use set extensions to make one stall look like multiple stalls. And I'm going to show you how I managed to make this effect. The first thing I want to show you is how I set up the shot in the studio, because that's actually really important. And it made post-production extremely easy. What I did was I filmed all our shots with the camera dead center on the toilet. And here's a small set that I recreated in Cinema 4D, and it'll kind of, in a way, show how I managed to create this effect. So we did all the wide shots with Bethany talking to the camera, with the camera centered on the toilet. After we were done filming Bethany, I moved the camera to the right until the stall looked like it would have been the left stall. And then we put someone in the stall and filmed them sitting in the stall with the doors closed, obviously. And then I moved the camera all the way to the left until the stall would have appeared to have been the right stall. And then we put someone in the stall and we filmed that angle. And then in post-production, I composited all three shots into one, and it made it look like there are multiple stalls with the perspective correct. If you were to do something similar to that than I did, you'd probably want to use a dolly so you can move the camera at the exact plane so you can keep the perspective exact and everything. I didn't have a dolly. I had to use a measuring tape, which works too, but you had to keep track of everything and be as close as possible. And in the end, it worked pretty well. Even though I wasn't exact, I was able to kind of fake it and make it look good. So the first thing we're going to do is go into After Effects, and we're going to import the angles that we shot in the studio. And the shots that we have are the center stall, the stall that looks like it's on the left, and the stall that looks like it's on the right. They're all the same stall, but the perspectives are all different. We need to import the left stall, the center stall, and the right stall. Let's go to the first stall, and actually we're going to create a new composition first. I'll go ahead and use one of these shots to create the new composition, and I'm going to trim this down a little bit to make it smaller on the timeline. Kind of spot that. That's good. Just trimming this down. Oops. Alright. Trim to work area.
Okay, here's the shot we're going to be working with, and we're going to make this look awesome. On the right and left of Bethany, you can see what we will be removing and replacing with the stalls. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in the left stall first, and we're going to go ahead and put it on top in the composition. So I'm going to go ahead and hit G and turn on the pen tool, and I'm going to cut out this left stall. Now I'm not going to be very picky here, in fact I'll just be really quick, because the shot is set up in a way that I don't have to be so completely accurate to make it look good. In other cases you might need to be more accurate, and to make sure it blends together with the other side, I'm going to go ahead and feather the mask I just cut out. And now I'm going to go ahead and bring in the right stall, and I'm going to go ahead and drag that on to the top. And then we're going to go ahead and do the same thing using the pen tool. I'm going to draw a mask up the center of the panel and around the stall to cut out that stall. So we can composite all the shots together nicely, I'm going to go ahead and feather this side as well. I need to reposition the center stall so that the perspective matches a little bit better. It kind of puts Bethany more in the center anyways. At this point, I mean, it looks really good. The only thing I would want to do maybe is to straighten this side out. It's a little out of perspective, so I need to make sure I'm editing the right one. Rotate. rotate it to the left a little bit, and then we need to reposition and rescale. That's just one little picky thing I would do for this. 101%. Okay. And there, I mean, that looks good. The only thing I might do is just add a curves effect. Curves effect to the panels on the side to match a little bit better the lighting. On the center stall. So we gotta match this one. We're gonna bring a curves effect on the right side. Let's bring it up a little bit. And that just, I mean, that looks great. That is how simple set extensions can be. The people, you can see their feet moving in the stalls on the right and left. I mean, it's just, it feels really dynamic. It feels real. And it's really easy. So now, what you want to do, well, I mean, you could render this out as is, but what I'm going to do is export the set extensions with the center cut out and transparent so that we can just put it right into Premiere and change the shots and edit it around as needed without having to go through this process a lot. And so we're just going to export this out, file, export, render queue. We want to make sure it's RGB plus alpha because that'll include our alpha channel, which is the transparent channel. We need that, it's really important. And we're going to save this to renders extension final. And I'm going to save this as extension final. Boom. All right. And we'll render it out. Okay, so we have this rendered, and what we're gonna do is go back into Premiere. Premiere is our final destination. So here's our shot in Premiere that needs to have the set extension added. And what we're gonna do is import what we just rendered, go to extension final, and I'm just gonna drag that clip right on the timeline, just right on top here. And I did make it really short, but it doesn't matter. I'm just gonna zoom in there. In After Effects, I had to adjust the bottom shot. So in Premiere, we have to do the same thing. So we're gonna change the position, the X position, until it matches the perspective correctly. And I mean, here we go. This set extension is now implemented. And it looks good. Thanks for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please write them in the comments. I will try to answer them. And if there's a good enough question that deserves a tutorial, I will make a tutorial on that question. So if you have a specific video technique that you want to see a tutorial on, please let me know in the comments and I will take those into consideration. If you want to see more videos like this, please support me by subscribing. Thanks again for watching and I'll see you guys next time.